There's uncertainty within the ranks of the new government over its English First directive. The Prime Minister's continuing to call the housing agency Kāinga Ora, despite signing a coalition deal with Winston Peters, promising government departments would be referred to by their English names first. Here's senior political reporter Benedict Collins.
It's season's greetings, Parliament styles.
And could I just make another statement by wishing the member a very Merry Christmas and the very best of luck in the new year in whatever role Kieran McAnulty gives him.
Suggesting the Labour leader's about to get rolled.
Merry Christmas to him too.
Chris Hipkins' return gift, an allegation of hypocrisy over the Prime Minister's taxpayer-funded Te Reo lessons.
If in the real world people pay for their own Te Reo Māori lessons, why did the taxpayer pay for his and will he pay that money back?
I think all 123 MPs in this chamber, if they want to learn te reo, that's actually a good thing.
While Mr Luxon's been unable to say how much those lessons have cost, to give him credit, he's been practising.
Kāinga Ora is New Zealand's largest landlord.
And practising.
Some of the most vulnerable New Zealanders depend on Kāinga Ora.
The problem is, in the coalition agreement he signed with New Zealand First, government departments should be referred to by their English names first. The party's leader believes te reo names confuse people.
Well, we know that the balance of the population and the significant majority don't understand that.
Oh, in line with government policy, I think it should have its English name first.
The housing minister isn't so sure.
Kāinga Ora is known as Kāinga Ora, Homes and Communities. I don't know a single person who calls it Homes and Communities.
Do the coalition partners know what Kāinga Ora's English name is?
Don't you know? Well, look, if you don't know, go back to Journalism School 101.
It should be called Housing and Communities.
Not quite, but they're not alone in not knowing that Kāinga Ora's English name is Homes and Communities.
Do you know its English name?
For Kāinga Ora? No, I don't actually.
You don't? Do you find that surprising?
Yes, I do.
What's its English name?
Housing New Zealand, I suppose, or Housing Development, yes.
Which one?
Housing, eh?
Which one?
Housing I don't know exactly.
Kāinga Ora? Housing?
Yeah.
Housing New Zealand?
No.
No, I haven't done.
Housing New Zealand? Oh, okay. There you go.
Another shot?
Not really.
No.
Housing New Zealand? Yeah. It's houses. Yeah.
Houses?
Yeah.
And the That's government good. Clearly bamboozled yeah. when it comes to using English First. Benedict Collins, One News.
After the government announced an independent review into Kāinga Ora, Labour says it could see a state house sell-off from National, while the Prime Minister's hit back saying it's all Labour's fault. Deputy Political Editor Mikey Sherman reports.
Labour hitting back on the government's 100-day plan, claiming the new housing minister's independent review of Kāinga Ora is a beat-up.
I suspect he's just trying to manufacture a crisis.
But Chris Bishop has concerns, many in fact.
What I've said is that I'm very worried about the financial performance of Kāinga Ora. Extremely complicated financial arrangements that the Crown has. I'm worried about the very large back office bureaucracy.
Putting the country's biggest landlord with 70,000 properties under scrutiny.
A broader housing disaster in New Zealand that got worse over the last 6 years.
But the former finance minister arguing nothing came across his desk to warrant such alarm.
There are always issues with every agency, but not the kind of unstated alarm bells.
Then, ironically, Labour raising its own alarm about a possible state house sell-off.
The National Party have a track record of undermining state and public housing.
I would note that the previous government was selling a large number of state houses.
This idea that the Labour Party stopped the state house sell-off is just fantasy.
The National Party, whenever they're in government, reduces the number of public houses, they don't increase them.
So we asked the Prime Minister to set the record straight.
Will you give an undertaking that the social housing stock in New Zealand will not decrease under your watch?
Yes, we want to increase state housing in New Zealand, but what's important here is that actually we take a comprehensive review of Kāinga Ora, which is a failing organisation.
Kāinga Ora debt has increased by almost $10 billion over the last 5 years.
Kāinga Ora have borrowed more money because they have built record numbers of new public homes.
Labour says you can't be trusted and you may sell off state houses.
Yeah, no disrespect, but I don't take lessons from Labour that left housing in an absolute mess.
Butting heads, business as usual for this house as it grapples with a familiar headache. Mikey Sherman, One News.